Hi, everyone. It's very exciting to be here today. Let me start by asking you a question. How many of you actually track your symptoms or know someone that is constantly or like has been told to track your symptoms? Raise your hand. Yeah. Raise your hand if you keep a diary of your symptoms, if you've been told to do it, or if you know of someone doing it. And keep it up if you fail doing it. All right. Why did you fail? One word. Annoying. All right. I failed myself as well. I didn't know where to start, right? Although I filled in the 3 copies of the exact same questions every time at the doctor's appointment, by the next appointment, 4 or 5 months later, I wouldn't remember them. Plus, it felt kind of awkward being at home and be like, all right, I think my knee hurts 1 to 10 or 5 to 10. How much does it hurt? It just felt kind of strange. And at the same time, I didn't really have much guidelines about it. And this is the point I'm trying to make here. Monitoring and documenting symptoms in chronic conditions are essential and are a key step in order to not only diagnose them, but monitor them and take action. The team you're about to see now, they managed to tackle this hurdle. And I'm not gonna spoil it anymore. I'm gonna let Manuel from Abaton tell you everything about it. Thank you very much. Manuel, come to stage.
Thank you very much for the warm intro, Pablo, and thank you very much for your continuous help during the program. So let's talk about chronic conditions. In Germany, 40% of the population is suffering from chronic conditions. That means, by definition, once you get diagnosed, you can't get healed. Luckily, through excessive research by academia and pharma, who paved the way to manage chronic conditions, make it possible to live more or less symptoms-free. But what is important about this? You have to adjust your treatment. So, this is where we start talking about monitoring. Unfortunately, in Germany, we have a ratio of doctors and patients, which is not equal, of course, that doctors don't have the possibility to monitor every patient in the optimal way. So, the system incentivizes the doctor to see the patient 4 times a year. 4 times a year means that there's always huge gaps where the doctor can't actually get insights into how the patient is, how the treatment of the patient is succeeding. Especially between those appointments, patients are suffering heavily from pain, swollen joints, and fatigue, for example. So how can you bridge that gap between 2 appointments? It's not stuffing more doctors, because the resources are limited. But this is definitely the way to go, to do a monthly assessment of the disease progression, gaining insights. And this is actually recommended. It's internationally, European, and Germany-wise, recommended by the guidelines to get the best possible treatment for the patient for the best outcome which is possible right now. And this ends up in the best possible quality of life of the patient. So now we know what to do. Track the disease status, monitor closer the therapy. And this is where we came up with our product, the Abaton Monitor. We know in chronic condition you have to monitor quite closely to adjust the best possible treatment for the patient. So our digital tool makes it possible for the doctor to prescribe it to the patient, that the patient can track his disease progression in a standardized, clinical, validated way in between the appointments. So, but why should a doctor do this? Well, we all know every doctor wants to help, every doctor wants to have happy and healthy patients, but they still have to feed their family and kids, right? So they have to earn money. We found a way and a code that the doctor can get this application reimbursed. There's a new regulation came into place 2016 in Germany. And this is also our business model. Our business model is that the doctor gets reimbursed per assessment. This is highly beneficial for the patient as well, because then you can adjust the best possible treatment to the best goal, target, and outcome. And we just ask for a fee for providing that tool, which makes it possible for the doctor to have a broader overview over all patients he has. So this is how we want to enter the market. We all know there's a lot of good digital products out there. But many products fail to reach the market by not knowing how to establish a business model. We got over this by a market, and we are going to target a market which is big, like 200 million euros. It's just the entry. So we want to add some features. Features, for example, gaining more insights into the medical treatment for better outcomes as well, and for pharma to develop innovative drugs in the future. This market is approximately 7 billion euros. And the long-term vision is, in a digitalized healthcare system, to provide the digital access to the patient, which is interesting for various stakeholders, with an estimated market of 30 billion euros. So who is doing that, or who came up with this idea? This is our team. It's me, having a broad international research experience from Boston and Edinburgh, as well as Munich. And I have worked in the healthcare system in Germany for 2 years, which makes it possible to address the market a little more specific. Hence, I'm just a research guy. It's the most important part and the core of our product is, of course, a digital tool. Our digital product, which was developed by Chris. Chris graduated in physics, successfully co-founded a software as a service startup 7 years ago, has 18 years of experience in software development, so he somehow is mature now, and has experience in leading a team of 50 developers at Fielmann AG in Hamburg. So we are looking for early adopters, and we want to make a case, especially for rheumatology in the beginning. So we are very happy to talk to rheumatologists who are willing to apply our tool in their daily practice to provide their patients a better outcome. We want to expand our network, as we know the German healthcare system is a system and not just a market. So we are very happy to talk to everyone who wants to join us as an ambassador on this quite interesting and interesting story. And we are happy to talk to interested investors who want to join our journey as well to make the German healthcare system a better system and to provide chronic patients better outcomes. Thank you very much for your attention. I'm very happy to talk to you afterwards in the back on our table, or send us just an email. We are always happy talking to you. Thank you very much for your attention, and enjoy the next talks. Cheers.